Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Aaron Sheldrick, and I work for Reuters. The Fukushima nuclear disaster has led to the shutdown of all of Japan's 48 operable reactors, as well as severely undermined public faith in atomic power. We're very fortunate today to have someone who can speak and throw unique insights onto the issue of nuclear safety in Japan. Hirohiko Izumida is the governor of Niigata Prefecture, which is home to the world's largest nuclear plant, Kashiwazaki Kariwa. The plant was also damaged by an earthquake in 2007, an event that was described by a well-known seismologist as Japan's last warning on the dangers of siting nuclear plants in such an earthquake-prone country. Izumida-san is not only a fierce critic of TEPCO's safety culture, but also of the central government, which he says hasn't sufficiently addressed how to resolve the issue of evacuations in the event of yet another disaster. We'll have some brief remarks from Izumida-san, first of all, and then we'll open up the floor to questioning. Please welcome Hirohiko Izumida. Hi.
Hello everyone. Please allow me to speak in Japanese today.
今ご紹介いただきましたが、早速ですが、資料に基づいてご説明をさせていただきたいと思いますので、1ページを開けてください。
So I've been introduced. I'd like to ask that you please turn to page 1 of the handouts, and I will speak according to the order of the slides.
このページはですね、今ご説明ありました2007年の時の柏崎刈羽原子力発電所の構内の写真です。
This is a photograph showing the Kashiwazaki Kariwa nuclear power plant site at the time of the 2007 earthquake.
この時火災が発生しましたが、事故対応を、知事の立場で、経験をしております。
I had an opportunity to experience what happens after an earthquake and the different measures that need to be taken after a disaster of this kind because I was governor at that time.
また2011年にですね、東日本大震災があった際には、福島県が新潟県の隣ですので、大変多くの避難者を受け入れをしました。スクリーニング、モニタリングもですね、実施をしました。
There was a fire at the 2007 earthquake, so that was a big event for us at the nuclear power plant. Also in 2011, when the Great East Japan Earthquake occurred, as you may know, Fukushima Prefecture is adjacent to our prefecture, Niigata Prefecture, so we had to take in a great number of evacuees. So we had were able to gain much experience in the screening process and the monitoring process.
2011年には日本政府、それから福島県と並んで、新潟県は東京電力からヒアリングをしながらですね、直接話を聞きながら、3.11 の事故を経験した組織ということになります。
Because of our very close involvement with the after effects of the Great East Japan earthquake and the nuclear disaster, we, members of our prefecture, Niigata Prefecture, joined members of the Fukushima Prefecture and members of the Japanese government in hearing directly from TEPCO about the events of March 11th. In other words, we were able to sit in on what we call hearings with TEPCO to receive detailed information.
3月11日地震の当日4時半にですね、すでに二次冷却水のポンプが流されて冷却不能になったというような報告がありました。
In other words, for example, on March 11th, the day of the earthquake, we were told at 4:30 that the secondary cooling pump had been swept away. In other words, it was no longer possible to cool the reactor. We received this kind of information very, very early.
話を2007年に戻して2ページ目をご覧ください。
I'd now like to go back to speaking about the 2007 earthquake, so please turn to page 2 of your handouts.
柏崎刈羽原子力発電所は2007年、震源から20キロぐらいの距離にあるんですけども、この原発の建屋から地面が1メートル半ぐらい、1メートル50センチぐらいですね、沈下をしました。
In 2007, when the Chuetsu-Oki earthquake occurred, this site, this nuclear power plant site was about 20 kilometers from the epicenter. However, as you can see from this photograph, the ground dropped a height of about 1.5 meters. It dropped about 1.5 meters.
これが火災原因になってます。
And it was this sudden dropping of the earth that led to the fire I described earlier.
一枚めくってください。
Please turn to the next page.
これが実際の火災の写真です。
This is an actual photograph of the fire in progress.
実は新潟県庁はこの時柏崎刈羽原発と連絡不能になりました。
At the time of this fire, at the time of immediately after this earthquake, unfortunately, the Niigata Prefecture Office was not able to communicate directly with the power plant in 柏崎刈羽。
仕方がないのでこれテレビで状況を把握するという状況になりました。
Because communication was severed, we had no choice but to watch events unfolding on television.
そしてワン店舗を置いて東京電力の本店を経由してサイトと連絡する間接連絡になりました。
We were also able to receive indirect information going through the TEPCO headquarters in Tokyo. In other words, TEPCO headquarters would send us information from the site.
ホットラインがなぜ使えなかったかと言いますと、ホットラインがある部屋のですね、ドアが地震で歪んで開かなかったもんですから、東京電力側がホットラインにたどり着けなかったのが原因です。
The reason that we were not able to communicate directly with the site is because there was actually a hotline, a special telephone line that was installed on the site. However, the room in which the hotline was placed, the door to that room became warped because of the earthquake. As a result, the TEPCO people were not able to get inside that room and use the hotline.
で次のページご覧ください。
Please turn to the next page.
なぜ火災が起きたかということなんですが、地震でですね、パイプがずれて、それで発火をしたということです。
Why exactly did the fire occur? The reason is very simple. As I mentioned, the part of the ground just basically fell at 1.5 meters. As a result, some pipes linking buildings were severed, and this was the cause of the fire.
フィルター弁当がですね、安全かどうかはこれ避難計画に大きく関わるので、この時の経験を生かしてほしいと思ってます。
This leads to concerns about similar things occurring with the vents. In other words, there are pipes that link the filters and the venting process is very, very important when we consider whether or not people must be evacuated. Therefore, what I'm saying is that this is the terrible thing that happened with the pipe severing in the 2007 earthquake. We would hope that the bitter experiences that we had at the 2007 earthquake could be used effectively for future planning to ensure that pipes for venting are not also adversely damaged.
で次のページご覧ください。
Please turn to the next page.
ここがですね、地面がずれたおかげで、パイプが外れて発火したポイントの拡大図になります。
This is an enlargement of part of the picture on the previous page. It shows you where the pipes that were linking two buildings basically were severed because there was a sudden change in the level of ground or the height of the ground.
で次のページご覧ください。
Please turn to the next page.
先ほどお話ししたように緊急連絡を確保する必要があると、いうことからですね、地震が来てもちゃんとドアが開くような、免震重要棟のですね、建設を当時求めました。
As I mentioned, one of the most crucial things that occurred in this 2007 earthquake was we were not able to maintain communications with the site. Therefore, we strongly asked TEPCO to create a separate building where this kind of thing would not happen again. In other words, we asked them to create what is called a seismic isolated building, one that is more or less impervious to shaking and one where the doors would not warp or just be distorted, where we would be able to get inside and communicate.
無論これ規制基準ではないんですけども、連絡が取れなかったことからですね、経験則上必要ということで、要請したものです。
Of course, according to the regular standards at that time, there was no need, there was no legal need to create such a building. However, based on the bitter experiences that we'd had in losing communications in the 2007 earthquake, we made a very strong request to TEPCO to have them create this kind of a building. Therefore, it was built.
結果としてですね、作ってもらうことになりました。携帯電話があればいいじゃないかっていう話もあったんですけども、これを柏崎刈羽に作ってもらうことによる安全確保を優先しました。
It wasn't an easy task, however, to get them to actually build this kind of a building. Originally, there were some conversations about can't you simply use mobile phones? Wouldn't that be enough to be able to ensure that you can communicate in times of an emergency? However, we were very adamant and asked that a separate building be built.
同じ東京電力の施設で、柏崎刈羽にだけ、この免震重要棟があって福島にないのはおかしいじゃないかということで、福島にも免震重要棟を作ることになって、完成したのが東日本大震災の8ヶ月前です。
As an extension of this, when the seismic isolated building was built in Kashiwazaki Kariya, we said to TEPCO, you have similar facilities in Fukushima. Isn't it strange that you would only have this special building only in one facility and not in others? And so for as an extension of our request, TEPCO built a seismic isolated building in the Fukushima plant as well. And in fact, it was completed only 8 months before the Great East Japan earthquake.
もしあの時新潟県が免震重要棟の建設を求めなければ、当然福島にも免震重要棟なかったですし、結果として今東京に人が住めていたかどうかは疑わしいと思っています。
In other words, in retrospect, if Niigata Prefecture had not made a strong request to TEPCO to ask them to build a seismic isolated building in Kashiwazaki Kariya, well, we would not have had one, and there would not have been a similar facility in Fukushima. And if there had not been that seismic isolated building in Fukushima, it's very questionable whether there would be people living in Tokyo today.
次7ページご覧ください。
Please turn to the next page, page 7.
これもですね、規制に基づかない対応を求めた例になります。
This is another similar example where we made a request to TEPCO that was not based on existing regulatory standards.
東電にも、当時、自主消防組織はあったんですが、しかし消防車持ってませんでした。消火栓が破断をしたので、結局消防隊は撤退することになりました。
In regard to the firefighting forces, it says a self-defense force firefighting groups. What it means is that TEPCO had its own personnel to be able to deal with fire situations. However, when the earthquake occurred, the Great East Japan earthquake occurred, some of the water pipes underground were also severed, and therefore the hydrants did not produce water. The firefighting force had no choice but to basically leave the site.
この自衛消防隊が機能しないというのは困るということで、体制強化をしてもらい、消防車を配備してもらいました。
Oh, excuse me. This was for the Kashiwazaki Kariya site. And so, based on again on this very bitter experience, we asked TEPCO to improve the situation and to be able to ensure that other facilities for firefighting were deployed at all of the nuclear power plant facilities.
この時の反省を踏まえて、消防車があったので、原子炉を冷やす代替注水が福島で可能になったと考えています。
I believe that in retrospect, it is because we made such a strong request that fire trucks and firefighting facilities and personnel were placed in Fukushima that they were able to find alternative ways to try to cool the reactors. In other words, to pour water onto the reactors.
で、次8ページご覧ください。
Please turn to the next page, page 8.
原子力規制委員会で新規制基準を作ってるんですが、安全性確保に対しては懸念を持っています。
As you know, the Nuclear Regulatory Commission or the Nuclear Regulatory Authority in Japan is, of course, making new regulatory standards. However, from a safety point of view, we do have some grave concerns.
まず福島事故のですね、検証総括がされない中で、今回新規制基準が作られているということに懸念をしています。
To be more specific, given the fact, as is described in bullet point number one here, given the fact that the Fukushima accident has not been thoroughly investigated and completely fully reviewed yet, the idea of creating new regulatory standards without this, with this incomplete background, I think is very...
まずですね、福島では8時間半後、事故から8時間半後にですね、すでに弁当するという判断をしていますが、現在停止されている、これ規格ではですね、18時間から25時間まで弁当は必要ないということでですね、申請がなされています。
For example, just as an example of the things that we find problematic, it has been shown that 8.5 hours after the accident occurred, there was a decision made by the officials to start venting. However, when we look at the new standards, it says that there is no need to vent until 18 to 24 hours afterwards.
それから原子力規制委員会が自らの所掌事務を小さくしようとしているというふうに感じています。
What that means, excuse me, is 18 to 24 hours after the reactor has stopped, there is no need for venting until that time. Although in reality, in Fukushima, the venting began 8.5 hours afterwards. In other words, what I'm saying, the thing that gives us greatest concern is that I believe that the NRA on its own is trying to shrink its jurisdiction, shrink its area of responsibilities.
制度設計上ですね、原子力利用の安全の確保を図ることが、その組織目的になっていますが、田中規制委員長はですね、規制基準の適合性をですね、調べているだけと、いうことで、実際に、IAEA のですね、深層防護の、基準全部を見ているわけではありません。
In other words, I believe that when you look at the actual law that established the NRA, it says that its fundamental mission, that's the reason for the organization existing, is to ensure that the safety of the usage of nuclear power can be secured. In spite of this, however, when we look at the work that the chairman of the NRA, Mr. Tanaka, is doing, he seems to simply be looking at very small technical details to see if specific sort of hardware standards have been met, if basically what is said here, performance standards is his main focus.
9ページに、規制委員会の設置法があるので参考で見てください。で10ページお願いします。
If you look at page 9, this gives you the actual translation of the law that established the NRA, and you can see that it is wide ranging in nature. It gives a great deal of authority to the Nuclear Regulatory Authority. However, I believe that Mr. Tanaka's activities do not go as far as some of the dangers that are presented by the IAEA. In other words, level 5 of severity. In other words, what to do after a very severe accident has occurred. Please now turn to page 10, excuse me.
深層防護のですね、第5層、避難についてですね、責任を持たないということ、それから第4層のですね、過酷事故の時、一体誰がですね、高線量下で作業するのか、で法令で言えばですね、上限線量を決められている中でですね、どの組織がどういうふうに動くのかというようなこと、また組織の運営能力等々もですね、これは基準の中から漏れていると認識しています。
So page 10 describes in detail more of what I was saying earlier. The IAEA identifies as different levels of dangerous situations. And in regard to level 5, this is what this approach is called defense in depth, looking at different layers of dangers. And in regard to the IAEA's fifth level of dangers, the response after a very severe accident has occurred. Basically, the Japanese NRA is basically saying we're not going to take any responsibility for that. We're not going to touch upon this issue whatsoever. In regard to the second one level lower, the fourth level of dangers, what happens in terms of a severe accident, what happens after a severe accident occurs, what is being done is basically... not enough by the NRA. For example, if a severe accident were to occur, there are many, many existing laws, and these laws stipulate who exactly can work in dangerous, high-level, high-radiation situations, and there needs to be much more refined work to determine who can actually do work in high-radiation situations. It has to be private company employees that must be able to work there as well.
また原子力防災の時に中心的な役割を果たす立地のローカルガバメントとのコミュニケーションを委員会が拒んでいるということから、過去の経験がですね、政府の施策に反映されない状況が続いています。
And so I've been explaining to you some of the concerns that we have, and I represent, I think, local municipalities who are very much involved in these kinds of evacuation and disaster prevention activities. However, in terms ofTrying to formulate these kinds of countermeasures for a nuclear power disaster, the NRA does not accept our opinions. They refuse to basically listen to our concerns. They basically do not communicate with us.
仕方がないんで、一般国民と一緒にパブリックコメントも出してるんですが、まともな回答がもらえていない状況です。
In other words, the lessons that we have learned as local municipalities are not being actively made use of by the NRA. Because the NRA will not listen to us directly, we have had to resort to basically participating in the public comments activities that are done by the NRA. We've joined the general public in voicing our concerns. However, even those concerns are not being taken into account.
Please open page 11. メルトダウン対策として例えばヨーロッパでですね、最新の原発コアキャッチャーがついてたり、まあ、アメリカはですね、事故が起きたら専門の部隊が対応する体制を取ってるんですが、日本はですね、事故が起きた時どうするかっていうことを法律も含めて対応をですね、今考えていない状況です。
So in regard to what happens in the event of a meltdown, other countries are taking very strict measures. For example, in Europe, the most new facilities have what they call a core catcher. They have cooling equipment underneath the reactor core. They, in the United States, they are specialized troops that focus on responding to an accident. However, in Japan, the question is, what will Japan do in case of a meltdown?There are no laws and policies put into place.
12ページご覧ください。
Please turn to page 12.
意思決定をどのようにしていくのかということについてもですね、もう少し踏み込んだルールが必要だと思ってます。
I believe that we must take a hard look at the decision making process and be very, very assertive in making new laws or new processes.
海水注入をめぐって東京電力は3月の14日15日になってもですね、真水で対応できないかっていうようなやり取りをしてますので、これは巨額のプラントをですね、使えないようにするっていう判断、保険がいるのか、責任関係誰が負うのかっていうところをもう少し明確にしないとですね、サラリーマンが5000億円もするプラントを使えないようにする判断ってできるのかどうか、この辺もですね、検討が必要だと思います。
To be very specific, you may remember that the idea of pouring seawater into the nuclear reactor to try to cool it down was considered for some time. However, even March 14th and 15th, when things were at a very, very difficult situation, crisis situation, TEPCO still could not make that final judgment whether or not to allow seawater to be pumped into the facility. In other words, we're talking about a huge, a very expensive plant. And for a salaried man, a regular employee, company employee, even if he is a president, to make that kind of a huge decision as to whether to allow seawater to be pumped in. In other words, this is equivalent to basically saying that we're going to write off a 500 billion yen reactor. I mean, that is something that as a company president cannot make a decision on. There needs to be a better legal framework in place. We need to be able to have a system where it's very clear who bears responsibility for certain decisions, if there is some kind of a guarantee or some kind of insurance system in place. Much more work needs to be done so that these decisions can be made quickly.
高い線量の中で作業が求められるケースっていうのも福島事故で明らかになっているんですが、民間と民間の契約で、法令違反になる、作業を命じることができるのかという点もですね、解決されていません。
I also think there needs to be much more of a legal framework to allow different persons and different organizations to take action in the event of a severe accident. For example, what happened with Fukushima is that when there was a situation where there was a great, very high radioactivity levels, when you consider the fact that most of the people on site were private contractors or private company employees, and when you're talking about they're working on the basis of private contracts between companies,Is anybody in the position legally to be able to order someone into a highly radioactive area that, according to the laws of the nation, is against the law? So obviously some kind of legal framework needs to be put into place, laws need to be revised so that private individuals, private organizations, private employees of companies can be ordered when necessary to enter high radiation level areas.
13ページご覧ください。
Please turn to page 13.
現在ですね、日本では自然災害が起きたときは、防災大臣が事務局になって、対策本部ができます。でも原子力災害はですね、原子力規制庁長官が、事務局となって、災害対策本部ができます。したがって、福島のように複合災害が起きると本部が2つ同時に立ち上がって混乱するという状況が改善されていません。
Another problem that we see is that the decision-making process becomes very, very complex. The line of command becomes very, very complex in Japan. In Japan, when a natural disaster occurs, then the state minister in charge of disaster prevention immediately sets up a headquarters in Tokyo. However, in the case of a nuclear disaster, then the Nuclear Regulatory Agency, which is the secretariat of the Nuclear Regulatory Authority, the head of this agency sets up his own disaster disaster prevention headquarters. In other words, you have, in the case of something like Fukushima, when you have multiple disasters occurring at the same time, you have two different kinds of headquarters.
例えば避難命令はですね、自然災害部分については市町村長が出しますが、原子力災害は、総理が出すということで、ここのところの整合性をうまく、取る仕組みが、できているとは言い難いと考えています。
In other words, because there were two separate lines of command, during the Fukushima, accident, this caused tremendous confusion. This fundamental, system approach has not yet been resolved. Another example that I can give you is that, when some kind of an evacuation order needs to be issued in the case of a natural disaster, then each of the local, municipalities are able to give those, evacuation, orders. However, in the case of a nuclear disaster, it is only the prime minister that can give the evacuation, order. So, otherwise, again, you have two separate lines of command, great confusion.
14ページご覧ください。
Please turn to page 14.
避難できない、災害時に助けのいる人たち、この方々をサポートするのにはシェルターを使う必要性もあるのではないかと考えています。
As you can see, one of the concerns that we have, in regard to evacuation policies is what to do about the people who simply cannot evacuate. They might be, disabled or sick. We need to provide shelters for people who cannot easily evacuate.
これで最後にしますが、安定要素材の配布について、規制委員会から指針が出されていますが、この指針が不可能を求めていることを懸念しています。
And, this is the last point that I would like to make now, which is, the last point here, the distribution and use of iodine, tablets. According to the standards that have been, set by the, Nuclear Regulatory Authority, there is a provision for distributing, iodine tablets. However, there are some, aspects of the regulation that are simply going to be impossible to achieve.
規制委員会では5キロから30キロ圏につきましては事故が起きたら屋内退避するように求めています。
For example, according to the regulations that have been set forth by the NRA, after a nuclear accident occurs, people living within a 5 to 30 kilometer radius of the earthquake location are supposed to evacuate indoors.
一方ですね、この5キロから30キロ圏の人たちに要素材を配布するのは事故が起きてから、配布をするということを求めています。柏崎刈羽の近辺には44万人の人がいます。
On the other hand, it is also stipulated that, the people in the 5 to 30 kilometer radius, must, be given iodine tablets after the accident occurs. This is almost impossible because even just looking at the Kashiwazaki Kariwa, site, there are 440,000 people living within that, 5 to 30 kilometer radius.
地元の医師会もですね、44万人に、事故後8時間半で弁当をされるというときにこれを配ることは難しいという懸念を有しています。
We've talked with, for example, people in the, medical, field, and they say that, in local, excuse me, the, doctors' associations, and they say that if there's going to be the presumption, the assumption that venting might start 8.5 hours after the reactor is stopped, being able to distribute iodine tablets to 440,000 people, in that 8.5 hours is going to be practically impossible.
NRA の規定をですね、現実的なものにする必要があるのではないかと考えています。
In other words, what I'm saying is that it's one thing to create a regulation on paper, but I think what they need to do at the NRA is to make realistic regulations.
あとは眺めていただければと思います。どうもご清聴ありがとうございました。
So I would like to leave more time for questions and answers, so I'm going to ask that you please look through the rest of the presentation. Thank you for your kind, attention.
Thank you very much for that. We'll open the floor to questions.We'll take questions from the working press first. One, please identify yourselves and your affiliation when you ask a question. One question per person and no speeches.
Siegfried Kittel, freelancer from Germany. You said the RA, the regulation, commission reduced its responsibilities. How can this happen? I think after, they, made a new kind of, this, regulation commission, I think it was all written in law. I don't understand how can the Commission itself say we are not responsible for this and this. We are only dealing with this. I think it's all. It must be. I thought it's all written in the law.
はい、ドイツのフリーの者でございます。先ほどの話の中では、原子力規制委員会の方が、自ら自分 の、 その責任範囲を矮小化したというふうにお話をされているのでございますが、これはどうして起こったんでしょうか。つまり、もう法律の中にこれ自分 の、 そのミッション、その委員会のミッション、その責任範囲というのはきちんと明記されていると思いますので、そういう背景にもかかわらず、その委員会の方が、自ら、我々の責任はそこまでいきませんとかって言えるというのはどういうことなんでしょうか。
これ制度設計上はですね、NRA が、原子力利用の安全に責任を持つことにしたはずなんですけども、人事なんじゃないかと思うんです。田中委員長はですね、現場の避難の責任を持つ、トップともコミュニケーションしてくれませんし、最近はようやく電力会社との意思疎通も始めたようですが、かなり言われてですね、初めて電力会社とコミュニケーションを取るということで、事故は起きるという前提でどう対応するかっていうことよりも、責任をどう回避するかっていうことでですね、委員会を運営しているんじゃないかと思われるということだと思います。で、それは原子炉等規制法っていう設置法ではない実態法がありますので、そちらの方に引きずられている面もあるのか、あとは田中委員長、法律家というよりは、技術系の先生ですから、技術のとこしか見ないっていうのが最初に方針で決まったのか、いずれにしてもですね、国民の生命安全を守るっていうところの意識がですね、どうしても感じられないっていうのが、この原因になっているような気がします。
As you pointed out, when we look at the actual formation, the law that established the authority, it says very clearly that the responsibility is to ensure the safety of the usage of nuclear power. And as to why the Commission was able to change its policies or its mission or the way it interprets its mission, I think has to do with the personnel choice, the choice of Mr. Tanaka as the head or chairman of the NRA. He was a person that has been very, very reluctant to speak with the different heads of organizations that were involved in the accident, or people heads of municipalities, for example, that were actually involved and had seen the after effects of these kinds of accidents. I've heard that recently he has at last begun to meet with the head of TEPCO, but for some time he was reluctant to meet with them, and I think probably he had some pressure behind him to try to start meeting with these kinds of people. In other words, his thinking is not about how to respond if an accident occurs, but it seems to me that the way he runs his committee meetings is the fundamental theme is how can we possibly evade responsibility if something happens. That seems to be his fundamental approach. There are also several laws. There's another law that exists regarding nuclear power usage, and it might be that he is looking more to that law than the law that established the NRA. But the point is, Mr. Tanaka is not a legal expert. He doesn't have a legal law background. He has a background. He's a teacher, a professor in nuclear technology. As a result, I believe that from the very beginning, he seemed to have made a decision that he would basically focus on technical matters and not others, other issues. Now, I cannot help but feel very strongly that he is not really thinking about this overarching, more important mission, which is to protect the lives and assets of the people.
Any more questions from the working press?
I'm Terry Jimbo with the Video News. Most of the things you said here and in your paper sounds to be very sensible and almost common sense. So my question is this: why is it that no one else but you bring this up? And what makes you able to bring this up while most of other people, including governors, mayors, even politicians, cannot. Thank you.
はい、ビデオニュースの神保でございます。今お話を聞いてて、そしてこのプレゼンテーションの内容を見てますと、書いてることは全部その非常に常識的なものばっかりだというふうに感じるんでございます。しかしながら、これは私の質問でございますが、なぜ他の方々は同じようなことを主張しないんでしょうか。他の、そしてまたどうして泉田様だけがこういうことを主張できるんでしょうか。例えば他の政治家、あるいは他の、県の知事も同じようなことをなぜ言えないんでしょうか。
2つ理由があると思うんですが、一つはですね、私自身冒頭でご紹介をしたように、地震に伴う原発火災を経験してます。それから 3.11 3月11日の東日本大震災の、原発事故の模様を東京電力から、組織の専門家の話を聞きながら同時進行的に経験をしていると、いうことからですね、何が起きるかっていうのをイメージすることができると、自信を持って発言することができるっていうことがですね、これは一つ違いとして挙げられると思います。
I think there are two reasons. There are two reasons that I can speak with assurance. One is, as I explained at the very beginning, I had the experience of seeing what happens when a fire occurs at a nuclear power plant facility after an earthquake. This occurred in 2007. So I've had first-hand experience with this kind of an accident. And secondly, on March 11th, after the Great East Japan earthquake occurred, as I mentioned earlier, I was in a very special position to be able to receive updated information in real time from experts at TEPCO. So it's because I was able to receive updated information constantly from experts and get the latest information, detailed information, I have the ability to kind of be able to predict and imagine what will happen next when something happens like this, when an accident occurs. It's because I've had this kind, these kinds of experiences that I can speak with such confidence.
原発立地地域の知事で作っている会議体もあります。今日説明した内容は実は新潟県単独の主張ではなくて、立地原発立地自治体の、知事で作る会の共通要求事項にもなってます。したがって、地震がない人は、新潟県の経験を踏まえてですね、そこに反対したりはしていないということです。
I would also like to explain that some of the points that I have raised and that we are asking the government to respond to are not simply the requests or demands that are presented by Niigata Prefecture. As you may know, there is an organization composed of the governors of different prefectures which have nuclear facilities on inside their prefecture. And basically, the points that I've raised are points that have been jointly agreed upon by this association of governors. And it, if, as you have pointed out, there are some governors that lack the confidence to speak out in a very, very loud voice, then that governor can certainly turn to the statements that have been issued by this association of governors.
もう一つの理由はですね、やはり先頭を切ってこの原子力の話で提言をしていくと、大丈夫かと心配する向きもあるんではないかと推測しています。
大丈夫かと心配するのか。
自分の身が大丈夫。
But I would also like to point out that none of the governors that belong to this association have disagreed with any of these kinds of points that I've raised. And another reason that some people might be reluctant to speak out is that even people around me, because I am at the forefront of vocalizing opposition or vocalizing concerns about the nuclear issue, even people around me are kind of concerned about what might happen to me. So I think I understand that other people might be reluctant to speak out as well.
私自身は2007年の中越沖地震の時に、問題だったところを直しておいてですね、結果として免震重要棟を作ったことが日本のためになったって確信してますんで、問題があるところに口をつぐむっていうのはやはり歴史に対する冒涜ではないかということで、問題点を指摘させていただいてます。
And as I mentioned earlier, because after the 2007 earthquake, I was very, very adamant that TEPCO take proper measures to ensure that future accidents do not occur. It was because I worked so hard on this matter that we were able to see the establishment of different facilities, such as the seismic isolated building. I believe, in retrospect, especially when we saw what happened after Fukushima, that these efforts that we made were for Japan. In other words, we saw that it was worthwhile to raise one's voice and to ensure that something be done, that this was something that we could contribute to future history. Because of this past experience, I can speak with great confidence.
Any further questions from the working press? Yes, please.
エコーニュースの江藤と申します。2点質問です。お話の最初の方に2011年に福島県などが行った東電のヒアリングというのがあったと思うんですが、それは今公開されてますでしょうか。ちょっと検索したところ見当たらなかったんですが、あともう1点目は、国との資料や情報のシェアリングについてでございます。実は、今年の初め頃に、うちの会社に対して新潟県の原子力安全対策課から、1984年に外務省が作った原子炉施設が攻撃された場合 のレポートを貸してくれないかと、そういうふうな要請がございました。でそれで、一体どうしてそれを新潟県が持ってないのか、国はそういうものをくれないのか、あるいはまた、そういう資料なんかをフォーマルに交換する場というのはないのか、はい、そういったところをお願いいたします。はい、
ちょっとごめんなさい。一つ目の方が意味が取れなかったんで、二つ目の方からお答えをします。レポートなんですけども、テロ対策等々についてですね、自治体に情報を共有してやっていく、特に外務省のレポートについてですね、共有する仕組みっていうのはないと、いうことになります。特にこれ確か報道で認識している限りですけども、このレポートが表に出ると原子力の安全神話が壊れて寝たかを起こしてしまうというような判断があって、政府内でですね、秘密扱いにしたということだったと思うので、当然自治体にはですね、そういう情報は流れてきてないということだと思います。一つ目の質問ちょっと分からなかったので、もう一度お願いできますか。
2011年に福島県などが東電に対して行ったヒアリングのお話がございましたが、このレポートのようなものは見ることが今可能でしょうか。
福島県が行った東電、
すみません、新潟県や福島県、国などが東電に対してヒアリングを行ったというお話があったかと思うんですが。
ですね、東電にヒアリングではなくて、事態の進展具合は東電から情報をもらいながら実際の事故対応に当たったということを申し上げたので、事後的にヒアリングをしたというのではなくて、3月11日は2011年3月11日は、例えば二次冷却水を回すポンプが壊れました、その次どうなりましたという情報をもらいながら対応に当たったということで、別途ヒアリングをしてペーパーを作ったということではありません。
Perhaps we could have a translation of the questions.
Mr. Ito from Echo News, excuse me, there were two questions that were asked. First was apparently a question about sharing of important information between the national government and local municipalities. Apparently after the accident in Fukushima, apparently Niigata Prefecture made a request to have access to a report that was prepared in 1984. By the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. It had to do with not a feasibility study, but a probability study about what might happen if a nuclear power plant were the victim of an attack of some kind. And my question was, isn't there some kind of a system for sharing that kind of information or disclosing that information? And the response was that the report that was being asked about was a report that had to do with counterterrorism activities. And at present, there is no system for sharing information of that nature, especially if the information has originally been prepared prepared by something like the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. And the reason for that, and not sharing that kind of information, and I only have this knowledge from what I've read in the news, is that because if such reports were made public or disclosed or shared too broadly with municipalities, it might lead to the destruction of what we call the safety myth for nuclear power plants. And that is something that the government did not perhaps want to have done. And the second question had to do with the hearings that the governor mentioned earlier in 2011, right after the accident occurred, that hearings were held between TEPCO and Niigata Prefecture and Fukushima Prefecture, and are there some kind of documents that are available to the general public? Have these reports or these hearing minutes been disclosed? And the answer was that they were not official hearings so much as that in real time, from immediately after the accident occurring, TEPCO sat down with us and gave us up-to-date information about what was happening, because by giving us up-to-date information, we were able to take the next steps, for example, deciding to evacuate certain people. Just as an example, on March 11th, we heard very quickly that one of the cooling pumps had been swept away, and so we had to make a decision as to what would happen next. But there is no formal report that was produced or no minutes that were available.
Tanaka of the NRA has constantly said that Japan has the most strict, the world's strictest safety standards. From what you're saying, and just to clarify, you're saying that this is not true. And can I also get you to clarify whether this applies to all of Japan and not just, say, TEPCO's fiefdom or TEPCO's area? Thank you.
田中委員長がよく言う言葉でございますが、日本のその、原発の安全基準は、世界で最も厳しいものだ、最も強固なものだというふうに言っているそうなんでございますが、今のお話を聞いておりますと、知事はこれは事実と異なるということなんでございますでしょうか。でもしそうでございましたら、この、 その安全基準が あんまり丈夫でないということなんでございますが、これは、東電 の、 その地域にあります原発についてだけおっしゃってるんでしょうか、それとも全国のすべての原発についてそのような指摘はされますでしょうか。
私、新潟県知事ですので、あくまでも県内にある、柏崎刈羽原子力発電所との関係で、どういうことになっているのかという評価の発言をさせていただいてます。で、日本のですね、新規制基準は IAEA のですね、深層防護の基準、第5層がそっくり抜けてますし、4層についても不十分ということです。法令の手当もなされていませんので、世界最高水準の規制ではないと考えてます。
So I would like to clarify, I am officially the governor of Niigata Prefecture, and therefore all of my comments are basically based on my observations about the safety standards and the safety situation in regard to the facilities within our prefecture. Specifically, I'm talking about the Kariwa nuclear power plants. However, when I talk about, when we look at the new safety standards that have been issued in Japan, as I've pointed out, they do not go very far, in my opinion. If you look at the IAEA criteria in regard to the defense in depth approach, in regard to the fifth level of safety that is described within this defense in depth approach by the IAEA, that what to do in regard to post-accident measures. Nothing in the safety standards covers that at all. In other words, that entire section is missing. And in regard to the fourth level described in this defense in depth approach, countermeasures for dealing with a severe accident. Some things have been mentioned in the safety standards that have been issued by the NRA, but I don't think they go far enough. So given this background, I cannot say that the safety standards in Japan for nuclear power plants are the strongest in the world.
Thanks. This gentleman down here.
フランス店の記者の及川と申します。せっかくブルーリボンをつけてらっしゃるので拉致問題について伺いたいと思うんですが、現在、北朝鮮の拉致、また交渉が滞ってきてしまってますが、泉田知事は、今の交渉どのようにお考えになっているか、そして、真の解決と呼ぶべき状況を作るために何をすればいいのか、以上伺えればと思います。
I am from Ten of France, and since you are wearing this blue ribbon, which shows that you are supporting the victims of the abduction issue with North Korea, may I ask about that? How do you view the current situation, the current state of negotiations, and what do you think would be necessary to create an environment so that this situation can be resolved?
現在の状況についてはですね、交渉が停滞状況に入っているというふうに懸念をいたしております。過去からですね、北朝鮮との交渉は難しいということですけども、特に行動対行動の中でですね、情報を小出しをしていく中で日本のカードが切れていくという交渉は日本政府として取るべきではないと。そもそも拉致をされた被害者側ですから、情報を出すところはですね、これは無条件に出してもらった上で次に行動対行動に入らないといけないというふうに思いますが、現実そうなっていないということからですね、進捗については大変懸念をしています。特に拉致被害者、曽我ひとみさんのお母さんと高齢になって、おられます。こういう被害者の、皆さん方のですね、心情ということを考えればですね、毅然とした対応をですね、やっぱりすべきだろうと、いうことだと思います。あと国際状況が変わった可能性はあるかなと、いうところもですね、目配せをした上での交渉が必要ではないかというふうに思っています。
In regard to the status of the negotiations, I am extremely concerned that we have entered a period of, I guess, doldrums, where things are not going to proceed for some time. The negotiations may have begun to stagnate. Of course, from the past, it has always been said that negotiating with our counterparts in North Korea is very, very difficult. However, the approach that is being taken by both parties is that you respond with an action, you offer an action, and you respond with an action. Fundamentally, this is not a bad idea. However, what is being done now is that the North Koreans offers a little bit of information, and based on that little bit of information being revealed, Japan responds with an action. But if this kind of little bits of information being repeatedly given and Japan responding with actions may mean that eventually Japan will run out of actions to offer. In other words, it will run out of negotiating cards to play. So I believe this is not such a good approach for the Japanese government to take. I think it is better for the Japanese government to take a very strong stance and say that we will not accept a little bits of information being revealed. We will want completely unrestricted access to information, and then we will respond with some kind of an action. The reason that I'm extremely concerned about this situation is that some of the abductees, for example, the mother of Ms. Hitomi Soga is quite elderly. When you consider psychological state of some of the abductees and their families, I think we need to move even faster on this situation as possible. And I believe that the Japanese government must take a very firm stance to ensure a resolution to this issue.
Niigata is at the intersection of many issues that affect national life in Japan. Let's go back to the nuclear issue. Do you think these concerns about the safety regulations, evacuation plans, is what is holding up, or not so much holding up, but is slowing down the process of restarts? I know you don't really want to comment on Sendai directly, but perhaps you can address the general issue of restart.
そうですね、ちょっとその原発の話に戻りたいと思うんでございます。今までお話を聞いておりますと、やはりその安全確保、あるいはその避難体制の作成などが、いろんな懸念があります、いろんな問題があるというご指摘をされました。こういうような懸念があるからこそ、その原発の再稼働への そのプロセスというのが遅れているというふうに思いますでしょうか。もちろん知事は立場上、その仙台原発の再稼働についてコメントをされたくないと思うんでございますが、一般的 な話としまして、まあ、こういうような懸念があるからなかなか再稼働に、移らないというふうに、進まないというふうに思われますでしょうか。
やはり住民の安全生命を守るということが知事の、最初のですね、任務だと思っています。再稼働の話をすると、福島事故の検証がですね、後回しになってしまうということを懸念しています。特に東京電力の場合はですね、先ほど申し上げた通り、このメルトダウンをですね、2ヶ月以上隠したというところがあって、事実を隠されると避難計画以前の話にですね、なってしまうと、そもそも運転する資格があるのかと、いうことになりますので、事実関係究明することが先ですので、これ再稼働については、一切、これは議論しないということでご理解をいただきたいと思います。
I believe that the first and primary mission of a governor is to ensure the safety, the lives and the assets, protect the assets and lives of the citizens of our prefecture. If we start to get into a discussion about restarting nuclear power plants, then nuclear reactors, then I think that the issue that I raised earlier, the need, the very strong need to have a full, thorough investigation and review of what happened with the Fukushima nuclear power plant accident, I think that issue will be set aside, will be lost along the way. I would like to point out that many of you may know this, that Tokyo Electric Power Company understood from a very early time, point in time, that a meltdown had occurred, yet they hid this fact for over 2 months. An organization does not reveal the truth about something this serious, you cannot make any reasonable evacuation plans. You have, the first assumption of an evacuation plan is that you have to be able to have accurate information. An organization that does not reveal the truth, that hides the truth, the question comes to mind whether they even have the right to be able to operate a nuclear reactor. So I think the first step that needs to be done is to have a complete assessment and evaluation about what happened with the Fukushima nuclear power plant accident and where responsibilities lie, et cetera. And until that is done, we cannot even begin to have a discussion about possibly restarting plants.
今再稼働は議論しないということでしたけれども、それは失言ではないかなと思います。やはり再稼働も、議論しないといけないと思いますね。福島の時に数ヶ月も2000数百名という方が命を落とされました。福島で、数ヶ月でも2000名以上の方が命を落とされた。しかし放射線によって死んだ方はいないんじゃないですかと当時の現職の官などと一緒に尋ねましたら、あれは光線量放射線の影響を考えての避難だったというふうにお答えになりました。しかし現実ですね、やはりバランスというのは必要だと思うんですね。稼働するのかしないのか、メリットデメリット、例えばその稼働をですねする場合のメリットというのもあるんじゃないかと思うんですが、知事はゼロだと思ってますか。
Do we have a translation?
Yes, I'm Fujita from the Kokumin Shimbun newspaper, and you said earlier that you did not want to even engage in a discussion or begin a discussion of the restarting of power plants issue. However, I think there is possibly a need to discuss the possibility of what to do after a restarting of the nuclear power plants. Several thousand people lost their lives after the Fukushima plant accident. However, no one died from radiation poisoning. What I'm getting at is the fact that I think one needs to take a balanced approach toward an issue of this nature. In other words, there are certainly disadvantages to having nuclear power plants, but there are also some positive aspects, benefits as well. I want, therefore, to first ask the governor for clarification. Some people say that there are benefits, merits to operating a nuclear reactor. Are you saying that there are absolutely no benefits at all? Zero benefits?
先ほどから申し上げている通り、新潟県知事ですので、私が議論する対象は東京電力柏崎刈羽原子力発電所の再稼働の議論ということになります。今の一般的な質問で日本全体どうするかというお話は答える立場にございません。で、柏崎刈羽原子力発電所に関して言いますと、そもそもですね、これはメルトダウンという大変重要な情報を隠す組織が原子力発電所を運転する資格があるのかどうかと、ここがやっぱり先であってですね、ここの議論なしに再稼働の議論はできないと考えています。
As I've mentioned earlier, I do speak in an official capacity, and I am speaking as the governor of Niigata Prefecture, and therefore all of my comments are very, very specific. The organizations that we deal with are TEPCO and the Kashiwazaki Kariwa nuclear power plant facility. So any discussion about restarting is limited to restarting any of the reactors in Kashiwazaki Kariwa. In regard to your question, which seems to be a much broader general question about what Japan should do overall in regard to nuclear energy, that is something that goes beyond the scope of my responsibilities and I cannot answer. But in regard to Kashiwazaki Kariwa, my position is very, very clear. We are dealing with an organization, TEPCO, which apparently and obviously hid the fact that there was a meltdown for 2 months. They hid this fact for 2 months from the public. And an organization that hides such important, crucial information from the public, my question is, do they even have the right to operate nuclear reactors? Unless we resolve this issue first, I cannot enter into any negotiation about possibly restarting any of the Kashiwazaki power plant facilities.
We're now at exactly 4:00. Can you take one more question, Izumeda-san?
Yeah. Again, he's a member. Twice.
He's a member of the working press. Are you a member of the working press?
Regular member.
Well, I've asked Siegfried to ask the next question. I'm the moderator. Thank you.
Oh. Siegfried Niedl, Germany again. When Mr. Yoshida, the head of the Fukushima Daiichi, died, he had a diary. It was published some months ago. And he said in this diary, he didn't want to run a power plant with six reactors. He thinks it is a dangerous thing to have a power plant with so many reactors. If I think much in my country, it's only allowed to have two reactors at one power plant. So Kashiwazaki has seven. So TEPCO wants to start two now. But I think they want to start the other a bit later also. What do you think about it?
またフリーのものでございます。吉田所長が亡くなったときに、その後彼 その日記っていうのが数ヶ月前に出版されたと思うんでございます。でその日記の中では、彼は、その原発、の所長を務める、ことにあたり、原子炉が複数あるものはそこでも所長にはなりたくない、6基があるということは非常に危険ではないかというようなことを書いておりました。で私の国であってもドイツであっても、一つの原発、のサイトにはやっぱり原発はにあすみません原子力発電所の中では原発を2つしか置けないというふうに思っているのでございますが、柏崎刈羽には7基があると思います。で今現在東電は2基を再稼働したいということでございますが、いずれはそれをも他のものも再稼働したいと思うのでございますが、それについてどう思いますでしょうか。
原発の安全性という観点からですね、お答えをすると地元の中にもですね、今、指摘をいただいた点についての懸念があります。ただこれ両論ありまして、数が多ければ多いほど生き残る電源が多くなる可能性があるという肯定的に捉える意見もあって、いっぱいあるとコントロールできなくなるという否定的な意見とですね、やはり両面これ技術的に検討していただく必要があるのではないかと思います。どちらがいいのかっていうのはこれ技術的専門的なところにやっぱり当たりますので、新潟県の中に技術委員会を設置してます。これは技術的なところとそれから組織の運営能力ガバナンスをどうするのかっていうところも含めた上でですね、議論をしていただかないと結論が出ないかなというふうに考えてます。
From a safety point of view, the concerns that you just raised have also been raised within among the residents of our prefecture. But apparently it's a very, very controversial issue. There are positive comments and negative comments. Some people say that by having multiple reactors, in the case you have an accident, some of them might survive, might continue to work, and they'll be able to provide electricity to provide cooling and other features. So there are positive comments, but some take a negative view, similar to what you've kind of implicated, that you might have many reactors being out of control. It's very, very difficult to answer this kind of question without the input of technical experts. And so in Niigata Prefecture, we have put together a technical committee to look into this matter. We have technical experts, and they're looking not only at the technologies, but they're also looking at organization management structures as well. In other words, they're looking at corporate governance issues as well. In other words, the technical committee is operating under the idea that you need to look at both the hardware part and the software part to ensure that accidents do not happen.
Thank you very much for that. I'm afraid we've run out of time. We've had a very interesting rundown on the issues that still face Japan more than 3 years after the Fukushima disaster. As the country moves towards slowly towards restarts. There's one thing left for me to do, and that is to present Izumida-san with another year honorary membership of the club. So hopefully you'll come back and update us again in another year or so. And thank you to our esteemed translator, Takamatsu-san. And please show your appreciation. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.